gather around mango lovers. It's finally that time of the year, the time of those perfect mangoes, the ones that taste like pure sunshine. They get you thinking, how do they get millions of those perfect mangoes from a perfect tree somewhere far away into our supermarkets, looking and tasting just perfect? There's a whole factory process involved. Ready to peel back the secrets? Let's go. And hey, before we slice into this juicy topic, hit that like button and subscribe for more awesome factory secrets. Harvesting. The gentle pick. All right, the journey starts way before any factory, obviously. It begins in sunny mango orchards, maybe in places like India, Mexico, Peru, or the Philippines, where these amazing fruits grow. And did you know that India alone produces nearly half the world's mangoes? Now, you might picture big machines shaking trees, but for most high-quality mangoes destined for export or careful processing, it's all about the human touch. Harvesting mangoes isn't just yanking them off the branch. Workers, often using long poles with cutters and catching baskets, carefully snip each mango, making sure to leave a small part of the stem attached, maybe about 1 centimeter. Why the stem? Cutting too close to the fruit can cause a sticky, milky sap to ooze out. This sap is irritating to human skin, and more importantly, it can burn the mango's skin, leaving ugly black marks and affecting its quality. Leaving a bit of stem helps manage this sap flow. Timing is everything. Pickers don't just grab any mango. They look for specific signs of maturity. It's not always about bright colors. Some varieties are ripe when still green. They look for the shoulders of the mango, the area around the stem to be filled out and plump. They might check the specific gravity, how heavy it feels for its size, or even test a few fruits from the area for sugar levels. Picking them at the right stage of maturity, usually when they are physiologically mature, but not fully ripe, is key. This allows the mangoes to travel without turning to mush and ripen perfectly later. These carefully picked mangoes are then gently placed into field crates, ready for the next step. Transport to the factory, the cool ride. Once picked, the clock starts ticking. Mangoes are delicate and need to get to the processing facility quickly and safely. They are usually loaded onto trucks, but these aren't just any trucks for longer distances or export-focused operations. Often, refrigerated or well-ventilated trucks are used. Keeping the mangoes cool slows down their breathing and ripening process. This prevents them from getting overripe or damaged by heat during transit. The field crates are stacked carefully to avoid bruising the precious cargo. Speed and temperature control are the name of the game here. Arrival and unloading, the first checkpoint. The trucks arrive at the processing plant, often a large facility buzzing with activity. The mangoes are carefully unloaded. This is the first major checkpoint. Quality control inspectors take samples from the load. They check for obvious damage, pests, diseases, and confirm the maturity level. They might cut open a few mangoes to check the internal flesh color and firmness. If a batch doesn't meet the required standards, it might be rejected or sorted for a different purpose, like juice or puree. Only the best make it through to the main processing line. De-sapping and washing, getting squeaky clean. Remember that sticky sap we talked about? Even with careful harvesting, some sap might still be present. The first step inside the factory is often a de-sapping process. Mangoes might be placed stem down on racks or passed through specifically designed channels that allow the remaining sap to drain away safely, sometimes assisted by a gentle water spray. After de-sapping, it's bath time. The mangoes move onto conveyor belts and enter washing stations. This isn't just a quick rinse. They usually pass through tanks or tunnels with water jets. Sometimes, brushes are used to gently scrub away dirt, dust, any remaining sap, and potential pesticide residues. Food-grade sanitizers, often chlorine-based solutions at controlled concentrations like approximately 50 to 100 parts per million, might be added to the wash water. This kills harmful bacteria and fungi, ensuring the mangoes are safe to eat and extending their shelf life. Thorough washing is super important for food safety. Hot water treatment, HWT, the tropical spa. Now for a really crucial step, especially for mangoes being exported to countries with strict pest control rules like the USA, Japan, or Australia. It's called hot water treatment, or HWT. This sounds weird, right? Giving mangoes a hot bath. But it's science. The mangoes are submerged in tanks filled with precisely heated water. The exact temperature and duration depend on the mango variety, size, and the specific pests being targeted, like fruit fly eggs or larvae. But typically, it's around 46 to 48 degrees Celsius, about 115 to 118 degrees Fahrenheit, for anywhere from 60 to 90 minutes. These parameters are strictly controlled and monitored using sensors and computer systems. Why? This controlled heat treatment kills any hidden insect pests, particularly fruit fly eggs and larvae, without cooking the mango. It's a mandatory quarantine procedure for many import markets, ensuring no unwanted critters travel across borders. It also has the added benefit of reducing some fungal diseases. Hydrocooling, the quick chill. After their hot spa treatment, the mangoes need to cool down fast. If they stay warm, they'll start to ripen too quickly and could get damaged. So, immediately after HWT, they usually go into a hydrocooling process. This involves immersing them in or spraying them with cold water. This rapidly brings their internal temperature down, halting the effects of the heat treatment and slowing down ripening. Quick cooling helps maintain the mango's firmness and quality. Drying. Getting rid of moisture. Mangoes don't like to stay wet for too long after washing and cooling, as excess moisture can encourage mold growth. So, the next step is drying. They travel along conveyors, often passing through drying tunnels. These tunnels use large fans to blow ambient or slightly heated air over the mangoes, evaporating the surface water. It's important to get them dry before the next stages of sorting and packing. Sorting and grading. Beauty contest time. Now the clean, dry mangoes are ready to be sorted and graded. This is where they get categorized based on quality, size, color, and ripeness. This used to be done almost entirely by hand, with trained workers visually inspecting each mango. While human inspection is still vital for final checks, many large factories now use sophisticated automated sorting lines. These machines can be amazing. Mangoes travel along conveyors under cameras and sensors. High-speed cameras capture images of each mango, analyzing its size, shape, and color. Sometimes, specialized sensors measure firmness. Based on pre-programmed quality standards, the machine automatically diverts mangoes into different lanes or bins according to their grade. Grade A export quality, grade B for local markets, maybe another grade for processing into pulp or juice. This ensures consistency within each packed box. Ripening rooms, optional. The gentle nudge. Remember how mangoes are often picked when mature but not fully ripe? Some factories have special ripening rooms to give them a little nudge before packing, especially if they need to arrive at the supermarket ready to eat. These are airtight rooms where temperature, humidity, and airflow are carefully controlled. The key ingredient here is ethylene gas. Ethylene is a natural plant hormone that triggers ripening. A very low, controlled concentration of ethylene gas, like 100 parts per million, is introduced into the room for a set period of around 12 to 24 hours. This initiates the ripening process uniformly across the batch. The mangoes are then usually vented and held at a specific temperature until they reach the desired ripeness level. This controlled ripening ensures the mangoes ripen evenly and develop their full flavor and color much more reliably than just leaving them on your counter. Packing, the final outfit. Finally, the graded and potentially ripened mangoes reach the packing stage. This is where they get ready for their final journey to the consumers. The type of packaging depends on the target market. For export, mangoes are often packed in sturdy, ventilated cardboard boxes. Each mango might be wrapped in protective netting or tissue paper to prevent bruising during transport. Sometimes they are placed in molded trays within the box to keep them separate. The boxes themselves are designed with ventilation holes to allow air circulation and remove heat and ethylene produced by the mangoes. The number of mangoes per box and the total weight are carefully controlled. Workers, or sometimes robotic arms, carefully place the mangoes into the boxes, ensuring they fit snugly but aren't crushed. For local markets or pre-packaged retail sales, you might see mangoes packed in plastic clamshell containers or on trays overwrapped with plastic film. Labeling and final checks, the ID card. Before the boxes are sealed, labels are applied. These aren't just brand labels. They contain crucial information: the variety of mango, the grade, the packing date, the farm or packhouse code for traceability, country of origin, and sometimes even a best before or ripen by date. This labeling is often automated, with machines printing and applying labels to each box. Alfonso mangoes are sometimes sold for over $1,000 per dozen in Japan. You surely wouldn't want that to be wrongly labeled. Before shipping, there's usually one last quality check. Boxes might be weighed to ensure they meet specifications. Inspectors might randomly open boxes to double-check the quality and count of the mangoes inside. It's the final gatekeeper ensuring everything is perfect. So they wash them, heat them, cool them, sort them by eye or machine. Seems pretty thorough, right? But I heard something wild from an insider at a massive mango export facility. They said sometimes, especially for the really premium mangoes going overseas, they use a special kind of light to look inside the mango without cutting it open. Forget color or firmness. They claim this light can tell them exactly how sweet the mango is. How is that even possible? Is it some kind of X-ray vision for fruit? Stick with me, because the tech behind this is seriously cool. Okay, ready for the secret behind that magic light? It's not X-rays, but something called near-infrared spectroscopy. It sounds super complex, but the idea is pretty neat. They basically shine a specific type of harmless near-infrared light onto the mango. Different compounds inside the fruit, like sugars and acids, absorb and reflect that light differently. Sophisticated sensors read these reflections, and computers instantly analyze the pattern. By comparing the pattern to a huge database, the machine can accurately predict the internal quality of the mango. Specifically, its sugar content, often measured as degrees Brix, dry matter, and even sometimes internal defects that you can't see from the outside. So, instead of just guessing based on color or feel or cutting open samples, they can literally see the sweetness and internal quality of every single mango on the line using this invisible light. It allows them to sort mangoes with incredible precision, ensuring that the super premium ones really are the sweetest. Mind blown, right? Using light to taste the sweetness. So, there you have it. From a careful snip off the tree, through sap draining, washing, a hot bath, a cold plunge, high-tech sorting sometimes with light, and careful packing, the journey of a mango to your fruit bowl is way more involved than you might think. Now that you know the journey of your mango, from jungle picked to factory sorted to possibly scanned by lasers, take a second next time you eat one, because that sweetness, it's a global operation, and it's kind of a miracle. Hit like if you agree, and subscribe the channel, and check out our other videos to discover the factory secrets behind your favorite foods. Catch you next time.